21 years ago, SpaceX was started by a man who knew nothing about building rockets. No expert was even willing to join his company. Elon Musk was on his own. Fast forward to now, and SpaceX is the biggest private space company in the world. From the three failed launches of its first rocket to recently launching the world's most powerful spaceship, SpaceX for sure has come a long way. So, let's go over the explosive evolution of SpaceX and check out how it became what it is today. Stick to the end because I have a really important announcement for you at the end of this video regarding my channel. So please subscribe if you're not there yet and let's dive into the topic. This is Adventures in Space. Let's start from the beginning. Elon Musk had a big vision. After selling PayPal in 2001, he had enough money to chase his space dreams. At the time, public interest in space was falling, and NASA's budget was not growing either. So Elon, as a true genius, decided to raise the challenge bar as per his enthusiasm and started a company to fulfill his vision of colonizing Mars. His big idea was Mars Oasis, which means a mini greenhouse on Mars. The plan was to grow plants there and show the world that life on Mars is possible. So, to make it possible, SpaceX set up its first shop in LA, as well as they bought some land in McGregor, Texas, for future rocket testings. Interesting to mention that this place was used for testing explosions since World War II. SpaceX's journey started with three people in McGregor working on Falcon 1. It was going to be their first liquid-fueled rocket. On March 24, 2006, Falcon 1 took off but did not get far. It rolled, pitched over, and crushed into the ocean. At that time, humidity was the main problem that caused corrosion and led to the failure. A tough start, but they learned from their mistakes. They started working for the next launch of Falcon 1, and then, weeks later, NASA gave SpaceX a lifeline. They funded the development of cost-effective methods to reach low Earth orbit. After several failed attempts, Falcon 1 eventually reached Earth orbit in 2008, becoming the first privately funded liquid-fueled rocket to do so. This success was a stepping stone to bigger things for SpaceX. After Falcon 1's success, SpaceX started getting orders for rockets. So Elon got straight to work on the next big thing, the Falcon 9. This time, the cost of the development rose to $300 million. But it was all worth it because Falcon 9 was not just any rocket. It was built to carry satellites and SpaceX's very own Dragon spacecraft right into orbit. They started on the first version in 2005, and by 2010, the Falcon 9 was ready to soar. One-third of a budget, or around $100 million, were put to the development process. What made it so special? The Falcon 9 had SpaceX's Merlin engines running on liquid oxygen and rocket-grade kerosene. It had a unique 3x3 pattern of 9 engines in its first stage. It successfully completed 5 missions, 3 of which involved docking with the ISS at the time. After Falcon 9 version 1, SpaceX decided that it would launch a Falcon 9 and Dragon spacecraft every 3 months. They aimed to double their speed in 2012. So for this mission, they made a big change and upgraded the Falcon 9 to the next version. The Falcon 9 version 1.1 was bigger, bolder, with 60% more thrust and weight than the original Falcon 9. The new rocket first took flight in September of 2013, carrying the Cassiope satellite on its 6th ever Falcon 9 launch. But like any new model, it had its issues. After its initial flight, there was a problem with the second stage engine restart. SpaceX, always learning, insulated the propellant lines to improve in-space restarts. The Falcon 9 also sported a jettisonable payload fairing, a first for SpaceX. The Falcon 9 version 1.2 was another big success, but Elon Musk and his team were not content to stop there. They had bigger plans, and those plans required more power. This is where Falcon 9 Full Thrust enters our story. The Full Thrust version was the answer to SpaceX's ambition to make the rockets reusable. Version 1.1 had made strides toward this with features like landing legs, but the Full Thrust took it to the next level. On April 8, 2016, it became the first rocket to complete an orbital mission and then land vertically. This was not just a one-time trick. Starting in 2017, SpaceX started reusing these landed boosters to send new payloads into space, pushing the boundaries of cost-effectiveness in space travel. By 2020, 81% of all Falcon 9 flights were reusing a booster. Fast forward to July 2023, and the Falcon 9 full thrust has an incredible record of 218 successful launches so far in this year. The cost? $62 million per launch for payloads up to 5,500 kilograms. But it still was not the best one by SpaceX. As SpaceX continued pushing boundaries, they unleashed a beast in the form of Falcon Heavy. Born from the success of the Falcon 9, the Falcon Heavy is essentially three Falcon 9s strapped together. That makes it the second most capable rocket flying, capable of carrying up to 63,800 kilograms into orbit. SpaceX didn't build Falcon Heavy just to show off, though. They made it to help us travel deeper into space, maybe even to places like Mars. In February 2021, NASA chose Falcon Heavy to launch parts of NASA's new Gateway outpost to the moon. Even though it is super powerful, Falcon Heavy doesn't cost a ton to launch. It's just $90 million, which in the world of space travel is a real bargain. Next up in our SpaceX story is Starship, their latest and greatest rocket. Imagine something as high as a 40-story building and weighs 11 million pounds at takeoff. That's Starship. Its total development cost is estimated to be between $2 and $10 billion. On April 20, 2023, this mega rocket roared into the skies from SpaceX's launch site in Texas, but sadly, it exploded less than 4 minutes into the flight. Yet, this was not a failure. It became the most powerful rocket to ever fly since the Soviet N-1 rocket over 50 years ago. The plan for Starship does not stop at these test flights. SpaceX is preparing it for some serious long trips, all the way to the moon and Mars. Elon Musk is planning on the next launch in a few weeks, actually, but it is definitely not certain yet, so please subscribe to the channel to never miss an update. And since you watched all the way to the end, I have an important announcement to make. Adventures in Space now have a membership area. You will have exclusive perks and a member badge, priority commenting, and early access to watch the videos. Also, your contribution will help Adventures in Space to produce content that you like. Finally, you will have access to community chat for open discussions, including the topics you want to learn more about. You can find all the membership info in the description of this video. And as always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and thank you for watching.